Start tonight's meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
and to the Republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you. Welcome everybody to the workshop. Tonight for our senior fund, let's set out with a roll call, please.
Supervisor Alvarico?
Here.
Trustee Boyce, here. Trustee Morelli?
Here.
Trustee Vickas?
Here.
Trustee Delaney, here.
All right, thank you. Any citizens here wishing to address the board here tonight? Seeing none, we're here tonight as a workshop and to approve a leasing program for our senior bus. I had it on the agenda the last meeting. At the last minute, the day before the meeting, or the day of the meeting, the Pace bus situation came up, and all of a sudden they appeared with two buses that they could lease us. After going through the lease bus, we tabled it because we wanted to have more time to think about this and decide which route we're going to do. Basically, we're in a question of our buses are breaking down constantly. Actually, we have another one down. We just rented a van for the month because we don't know how long it's going to take to get the bus fixed again. So we're down to, we have to do something. We can't kick this thing down the road any longer. So we have three choices, I would think. We could buy buses, we can lease buses, or we can go to the Pace bus program. I did ask our attorney to look into the Pace bus program. And did everybody get a letter in their packet now? Should have come. Is it in yours now? I apologize, just getting it to you today. Gary sent it to us on Friday evening at 4 o'clock. So I couldn't get to you any quicker than this morning. Basically, he's saying because of the referendum, and I believe everybody has a copy of the referendum that was passed. Basically, to make the purpose of providing services to senior citizens, solely an exclusive purpose of providing services to senior citizens. The Pace bus basically says that we have to use it for the general public and the handicapped. And if we use the senior fund to do it, we can't use these Pace buses. So really, the Pace bus program, we can't do it. So that gets us down to the leasing or buying. We did go through the leasing program. The National Auto Fleet Group. It's my suggestion, and I would hope the board would approve it tonight, to lease the two buses that we had talked about.
And that's a 3-year lease,
right? It's a 3-year lease, yes.
And at the end of the 3-year lease, we basically purchase them for $1.
$1. Okay.
Or we
can turn them back in, and buy new buses. Okay. Which has been the, before we took over the buses and stuff, and it was just farmed out to another company, Standard Shuttle. What they did was they get new buses for $1.
Okay.
They, you know, buy it for $1, and that would be the down payment to the new buses. Which, you know, we got 3 years to decide that, but that's probably not a bad idea.
My only question was, I thought on that agreement that was handed out that there was two separate quotes. There was one where you buy the bus for $1 and it's ours, or we know, in fact, we're going to give them back in 3 years. Is that right, or am I wrong on that?
Well, one was a purchase.
See, I don't have an agreement. I thought that was going to be.
One was a purchase,
and
one was a lease.
I should have had the
shelf. Because I know there was actually two different payment plans, I thought.
Right,
there was. Right. And I thought
it was like $2,900, one was $2,400.
Right. And I didn't know if...
Okay, this is what you're asking for, Dean.
Okay.
So there's that one and there's that one.
Right, now are these different, like I said, for a reason? Because I thought maybe one... See, this one here is where you're buying a purchase option for a dollar for the 28. And that one there is purchase, it's your fair market value. Right, it's basically you send a turn, you're going to give you a credit.
Towards.
Or a new bus.
Yes, new bus.
Well, right, you know.
This means we wouldn't get... We could buy them at fair market value. Or we just turn them in and we don't get any credit for them at all.
And we, but we just keep the lease going.
We can sign a new lease for a
renewal.
So it would be basically this same style of lease. This lease here is actually more of a buy term.
Because at the end of that lease...
You're buying them.
You're buying them for a dollar.
Right, and that way we can sell for another year or two if we think they're in good shape. But that's what I'm getting at, to feel better. You know, I thought the plan was every 3 years we're going to update.
That's the indication.
So that would be this plan here.
So there's about a $500 difference in the...
Right, is that the way to go?
So $500 over 36 months is $18,000. Is that vehicle going to be worth $18,000 for trade-in in 3 years? I don't know. I'm not a car dealer.
Right.
You know, I have to go by the Michelle's opinion, the opinion of Michelle, because she's been running bus services for 28 years. And she's indicated to me it'd probably be better to just keep on leasing. You get new buses and you have less.
Well, that's after both of these plans are kind of the same.
Yeah, I mean, turn them in and get new, just lease, keep on leasing.
So
don't leave it for a year.
Okay.
What you fall into is then you start getting into your
maintenance costs
that are pretty strong after. You know, like we are right now, we have a $10,000 maintenance cost.
How old are the events that we have left?
2012.
But when you purchase them, they have how many, like 40,000,
49,000, I believe.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, I don't know. I'm under the impression that that's 30 miles. 40,000.
Oh, when you bought me, right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I know they are diesels, and that's an issue, I guess, mm-hmm. causing more problems. These are not diesels.
Those are gas.
Right, which is a positive, but...
And they're brand new?
Yeah,
they're brand new. You know, like I said, I guess my only question is which one of them go with. I mean,
and what is the turnaround time once we say to go ahead with whatever lease?
The buses are going to be built in 6 weeks.
6 weeks, okay. I mean, obviously there seems to be a need for the buses.
Well, there's definitely a need for the buses.
I don't know, but you just mentioned, Dean, it just depends on which way we want to lease. I did have the opportunity to look at the PACE program, which I really don't see any advantages to going to the PACE program.
No, I don't either.
So, like I said, I don't have a problem moving forward with these, whichever these we decide to go with. But as far as, you said the many years of experience that Michelle had, she's recommending to go with not a $5,000.
And like I said, I have to, you know, I'm not a big, never had bus service, you know, running the direction, staying in the shuttle.
It's only two.
How many miles do they have at that?
So we trade in our vehicle.
I think they're in the 80s, 90s.
How many miles do the bus have on them now?
One's got 80, one's got 70. One's been down about 6 months ago, 10,000 pounds plus.
But they've been down a lot too.
Yeah, we have shot so many times.
So what will you do if one of them breaks down between this 6 to 8 week period?
Oh,
just keep on renting. Fixing them or renting something?
Well, we're going to have to rent. We got a bus or a van rented for the month now.
Oh.
If the bus, we just brought it down to rentals on Friday, we're going to find out what the cost is going to be to fix it. And we're just going to have to play it by ear and see.
So With the leases right now, if we go into these leases, are they gonna take, what are we gonna do with the vehicles? Two buses we have. They're gonna take them as traded, and they're gonna give us 14.5 traded on each one, on each one. Right. So, just so we understand this quote. I mean, we give the buses, then we just start the monthly payment? I mean, is there a fee we owe?
I don't believe so.
Is that, I mean...
The monthly fee.
Yeah, we'll get the right of the lease agreement if you want. Exactly what's gonna...
Whatever it is, I mean, the money is in the budget for fire. We have $79,000 in that line item to buy buses. Leasing will be under $35,000 or something like that, if I remember the right, that would be right off my hand. It'd be,
Well, yeah, we'd go over it, if we look at the letter.
I will tell you this also, I've been doing the research, because of the question being asked about the bus service. I know you were asking about how many people ride the bus, and all those questions. When we took over the bus system a year and a half ago, almost 2 years ago, 2 years in November, we were saving about anywhere about $6,000 a month now, since we've taken over the house. So it is saving a lot cheaper to run the service for us. I think that's pretty good that we've, you know, saving that kind of money.
Buses. Where is that savings coming from?
Just from the cost, the monthly cost. We figured out what the monthly cost is.
And what we used to give standard shuttle every month?
You know, that's...
Even with us paying for the drivers?
The drivers, the insurance, the administration cost, the fuel, the bus insurance,
Probably the biggest is the insurance, because we pay it through Torma, so nothing doesn't come out of our pocket, correct? Yeah.
What's Torma?
Torma is our liability insurance on all vehicles.
It's run by the Township of Illinois.
Is that of the lease? So anyway, I would suggest that we make a motion to approve the leases of the National Auto Fleet Group.
Which lease?
Right.
I would suggest that we, I mean, they're within $5,000. We have line item money here. I don't care which one we do. I think we should, like I said, have to take the opinion of our lady that's been...
Well, both of these are replacement every 3 years.
Mm-hmm. When they come back, another
time. Right, we're paying another $18,000 to buy it for a dollar. That's assuming the vehicles are worth $18,000 at that point. You know, the residual value must be $18,000 on these.
I would just be more comfortable doing the lease that just rolls it over to 3 years.
We're at the end of 3 years, we turn them in.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't see it in the lease. Is there a clause on how many miles are allowed on these buses? Are we going to go over that amount of miles?
I don't believe it. I didn't see it in that lease. It's been a practice of standard shuttle, and we're going through them to get them under 100,000 miles. At least by the end of 3 years, you're getting close to 100,000. So that's why we always
turn it in. Okay, but like on mostly, if you lease a car, you're on $15,000 a year. Is there a provision in this lease that...
There's a warranty, but that's not what you're asking for.
Well, we get 3 years, 36,000 miles per month or so. 36,000 miles is probably going to be gone in a year and a half. Mm-hmm. Right? I mean, if we're figuring about 24,000 a year.
We use the buses a lot. I mean, they're always going.
Well, Well, I had contacted Michelle because I had a lot of different questions, and she gave me all the information on like how many people use it daily. And it seems to be that they're used on the average, you know, 20, 30 some people on a day-to-day basis, excluding weekends.
Right, yeah.
Well, then I guess I would like to make the motion to go ahead with the lease that is,
That rolls over the buses.
That rolls over the buses. That's the recommendation of Michelle, who's been obviously managing these buses for many years.
Do I have a motion?
I'll second it.
I got a second. Any other questions? Can I have a roll call, please?
Alberico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli?
This one.
He has one more question.
I'm trying to come up with that number. Amount, about the amount financed. So, is that what they're saying our total is going to be after 2 years?
After 3 years, it's going to be 36 times 2371.
Okay. Which?
Well, on this one here, if we plug in that other number, I bet you this comes up to the 95,668. 36 times 2895.
Right by your constituents, so.
Last time we bought the buses, we were in. In an emergency situation. The bus service ended its contract in 3 days, we had figured out what we're gonna do, so we bought buses.
I mean, we got a couple months.
We didn't know what the bus, we never had a bus service, we never ran it in-house before, it was kind of thrown in our laps, we had 30 days to figure it out. We made it work, and now it's time, and I appreciate you guys asking the questions, you know, right? We'll be back in the leasing room, getting new buses every 3 years, wanting to keep them. Just food for thought, I would like to eventually have a backup van, maybe next year, maybe a year after that, if you can feel it. That way, when one bus does go down, it's no problem, we can have a backup van, and we can, there's some times when the buses aren't being driven, and we get another call, and one of our secretaries was a CDL driver, so we'll go up there, you know, to do it someday. She's a personal car, but I always feel it's comfortable, they don't want to say no to any festivals, that's the reason why.
How hard is it to, in an emergency situation, to just rent that van? I mean, is it just a matter of like renting a car?
Yeah, you can get it pretty quick, but.
Is it expensive?
It's, we've gotten pretty cheap sometimes, we've gotten kind of expensive sometimes.
Where are you renting it?
Like how much?
Enterprise, Lockport Enterprise didn't have any van assistance, so we had to go to Orland. And they're charging us. So, you know, it's.
I mean, it's.
The situation comes up, you kind of like, you start calling around. Actually, Kevin, one of our drivers found about a year ago, found the van. Yeah, we'd be driving by one of the rental places, and they pulled in there and said, how much? And we got to do it. You never know, you know.
I mean, is it $1,000? I mean, I don't even.
I can't remember right offhand. I think that cheapest one was about $1,000 a week. No, the one, remember the one you had found?
Well, I had a friend in Baker, Tom Green, on Lockport, the manager, and we were renting for $30 a day. And he didn't charge us for a weekend, but he moved on to another job. You lose your connection, you know.
Yeah.
We went to Enterprise, $1,000 a month.
No, it's not
that bad.
No, you have to do occasionally.
The convenience of the riders too, because it doesn't have a wheelchair lift.
Right.
It's hard to get in, and you have senior truck in there. You know, then we got the one bus that's working, we got to figure out, okay, who has wheelchairs this side and that side. Or you have a half a day, and we're going to be a bus on this side for half a day. You know, so it's a little bit of a hassle.
Both of these buses are.
Yeah, both of these buses are really good, accessible, and we need to do this. So 9 years. Yeah, this will be, nice buses, and I appreciate you guys not proving it tonight. So we bought a couple of lemons, we were like under the gun last time, we bought what we could find.
That's for some understatement, right?
Yeah.
I think like Denise said, though, the pace, after all that, it's like that last meeting, like all of a sudden,
when
nobody
pace
really
first came to
do.
To the table to me, I thought it was a good idea. I really did. And the more and more I got into it, there was a lot of paperwork involved in it, a lot of rules and regulations, this and that. I don't believe I just didn't.
Well, one of my main reasons for wanting to see the pace, I thought it would alleviate a lot of responsibility on the township. Where it doesn't.
No.
I mean, you're still responsible for hiring the people, you're responsible for the insurance, the paperwork, the
We already pay the pace for dialogue system for the for our handicapped and the other.
And how much do you pay them back a month?
But there's
Yeah, there's City of Joliet, Homer Township, Joliet Township, Lockport Township, Plainfield Township, Troy Township.
What does that $1,600 go for?
It's for the ridership. So here's the way it works. Everybody that's within the city limits of Lockport, Crestville, and Romeoville, Crestville, and Lockport pickup. So we pay it.
Okay.
Then we get reimbursed from the city. So it ends up cost us near nothing. All right, I have nothing else. Is there anything else anybody else to bring up? Hearing none, I would call for a motion to adjourn.
Make the motion.
A motion by Barb, please.
Second.
Second by Delaney. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Thank you very much, everybody, for your time and patience.